That was an impressive study in female patients with chronic myelocytic leukemia, international survey of pregnancies in that women group. And it appeared that in the majority of pregnant women, this finished in a labor with healthy babies, only a few congenital abnormalities, 1.7%, which is in the ballpark of what we see generally in the general population. And I think the importance of the study is in particular that in comparison with 20 years ago, when tyrosine kinase inhibitors were not available, we transplanted patients, allogeneic transplant, within the first year after diagnosis, losing their fertility, if you talk about females, and having a chance of dying from the transplant procedure, transplant-related mortality. And now, since the introduction of imatinib and the second, third generation of tyrosine kinase inhibitors, there's longevity. These patients live forever, I might say, 95% at 10 years, without signs of disease. It's a deep molecular remission. And so things like pregnancy, or in other words, a normal life, are most important and are in the picture now. That's why this analysis is important, and it also supports women with CML to become pregnant and not stay away from it. It's in particular an implication for practice in women, I would say. If they are in the age of fertility, they are looking forward to getting kids, they could do it under good guidance of their hematologist, of course.